Hi, my name is Deborah Acker, and I'm an intuitive energy healer, and I help clear childhood patterns, pain, trauma, and abuse. And in today's video, what I want to talk to you about is really how our childhood patterns can really be creating our present-day reality and what we can do to begin to change those. And I love to give examples. So first of all, I want to give you a couple of examples to help you to better understand how this might apply in your childhood. And one of my favorite examples that I love to give is, say you're 5 years old and you ask your mom for a piece of chocolate. And in that moment, of course, our parents just want the best for us, right? So she says, no, you should have an apple. In that moment, you might make up that you can't have what you want or you don't know what you want because obviously you have this authority figure, your mom, telling you, nope, this is what you should want. And you wonder why, you know, in your present day reality, you're magnetizing rejection. And it's literally from something as simple as something that happened when you were 5 years old and you were asking for something and you didn't get what you wanted. Let me give you another example. Say you are 7 or 8 years old, right? And you wanna go over to your best friend Molly's house. I did not have a best friend named Molly, but say you wanna go over to your best friend Molly's house, right? And you happen to notice, your mom doesn't say anything, but you happen to notice that your mom is disappointed because she was hoping to spend some time with you. In that moment, you know, you might end up going, but in that moment, you might make up that if you put yourself first, right, if you choose yourself, and again, this would be subconscious or it would be mainly unconscious, right, it wouldn't be conscious in that moment, but in that moment, you might make up that if you put yourself first, others get hurt. And then you wonder why, in your present day reality, why you have a hard time putting yourself first, right? Or why you have a hard time choosing you. And it's literally from something as simple that happened when you're 7 or 8 years old with your mom. And so think about it, right? I just gave you two examples. Think about thousands of moments like that, right? And thousands of conclusions, all subconscious and unconscious, that are made, right? And how that's magnetizing your present day reality. And I always say to my clients, you know, it's like you're wearing I love this image. It's like you're wearing a 300-pound bodysuit, right? So you're wearing a 300-pound bodysuit of what I call our inherited truths, right? The truths that we take on from our parents that feel like our truths, but are they really our truths? You know, that's part of the journey, right? Part of the self-discovery. And so it's like you're wearing this 300-pound costume, and literally, though, you think you're wearing like a sheer bodysuit. And so, you know, if you imagine this, it's why we feel so heavy so much of the time, right? Because so much of the stuff that we're carrying around isn't even ours, but we think it is. And so, you know, those are a couple of examples. And just think about, like, in your life where you might have made up some conclusions, right, that are now impacting your present day reality in a big way, right? Maybe you're not magnetizing, you know, the person you're wanting in your life. Maybe you're not getting the job that you're wanting, or maybe you're in a job that it makes you unhappy, right? But you're in it because you took on some truths that you should be doing. You know, you should be a doctor, you should be a lawyer, right? Or because that's what was the family, you know, the family business. So just noticing how that applies and where that applies in your life. So most importantly, what do we do to begin to change this? I know most of us don't, and when I started this work, actually, I didn't either. So most of us don't have memory, you know, don't have a lot of our childhood memories, right? We don't remember a lot of our childhood memories. And in the work that I do with my clients, what I go in and do as an intuitive is I go in and look at, okay, at age 5 with your mom, these were the conclusions that were made that are now impacting why, you know, you're struggling in your life in this area. And most of the time, like I said, my clients don't remember that that happened. But then when I say it, even if they don't remember the exact moment or the exact memory, they like somehow in, you know, in their body, it lands as truth, right? Because they know, they're like, oh my God, I did take that on. I don't know why, but that just feels true, right? We can always feel when something is true, you know, for us, even if we don't remember the exact moment or the exact piece. So the first piece of it is always awareness, right? And it's really important, you know, that you have that awareness of like, oh wait, this was the conclusion that was made. The second piece is giving voice to that little girl, that little boy that lives within each of us, giving the voice to be able to express like the impact that that parent had on them, and also be able to, you know, to give them the voice to be able to express that if they were scared, if they were hurt in that moment, all of these different voices that, you know, that why, you know, many times why we're recreating that moment over and over and over again as an adult is because we want to have that voice. And we didn't have that voice in that moment, of course, because we didn't have the consciousness, right? And so a huge part of clearing that energy is giving voice to that little girl or little boy that lives within us and giving voice for them to say, it really hurt me when you said no to me. Or, you know, I was scared to put myself first because, and fill in the blank, right? And so it's really, really important. That's a huge part of what takes the energy off. Another thing that I do in the work with my clients is I do energy clearing, right? So, you know, in addition to taking the energy off by giving voice to it, which is really important that you have someone helping you through this and helping you to determine where the energy lies. Many times when I'm working with my clients, I'm able to look at and say, okay, wait, this is what your little boy or little girl needs to say, right? And it's really important that it's like very specific and it's not just you retelling the story over and over, which is really, really common. Many times, especially, you know, as we're working to create change, we end up telling that story over and over and over again. And so those are my two recommendations in terms of how you start to take the energy off of a pattern and really looking at, you know, as you go on this journey of self-discovery, right? And you're looking at creating the life that you truly want for yourself. It's really, really important to look at, okay, your childhood and the things that you took on in your childhood. So if you're interested in exploring this further, I'm traveling around the country doing, basically it's called Clearing Patterns and Pain Energy Clearing Workshops, and they're from my Love, Light, and Abundance Workshop Series. And so I'm traveling around the country. I would love to see you there. If you're not able to make it, I'd still love to see you, right? So don't hesitate to reach out. I have a special offer, it's a one-time special offer for a $99 energy clearing session. So if you feel called to move further, or you feel called to explore and to investigate what conclusions you made, definitely don't hesitate to reach out. You can find out more about me at www.deborahacker.com. That's DeborahAcker.com. And you can email me at deb@deborahacker.com. Look forward to connecting with you soon.